So Max Taylor from BBTV, the main man here, the main star of the show, hopefully Saturday night, Joe Cordina, how are you,
mate? I'm good, my man, thank you very much. Yeah, just got the presser done, and I'm just looking forward now to weighing in tomorrow.
What is the anticipation like? I know my experiences won't compare, but I used to box as an amateur, and even the few hours before, the anticipation would kill me. So having to do these media rounds, I'm sure you're so used to the fight week now, but kind of what are your feelings, you know, in the days beforehand?
To be honest, I enjoy all this. I enjoy all this stuff. It's part and parcel of what I'm doing, and I know I have to do all these things, so why not embrace it? You get all the youngsters that are coming, they don't have the opportunity, especially from Wales, they don't have the opportunities to be on big shows like this, so I see them loving all this sort of stuff, so I should do the same. But yeah, sometimes it can get to certain people. For me, it don't. I've been at the highest level in boxing, which is the Olympic Games. And yeah, that was the most nerve-wracking I've ever been. But since I turned pro, it's been a walk in the park, really. I don't really get nerves. I get butterflies just as I'm walking up. And yeah, that's all it is for me.
Well, I was watching a lot of the stuff you've done with Matchroom and the content and stuff, and Tony's just beside us now, and he was saying about how you guys were working so much on the shot that you had landed to knock out Ogawa. Going into Saturday, is there a shot, can you give that away, kind of what you've been really perfecting and preparing? Is there something special that we're going to see on Saturday in your locker?
No, we've worked on a lot of things in this camp, how to nullify what he does. But yeah, not like the last one. It was one or two shots where we thought, yeah, we can catch him with ease comfortably, and one of them was put him to bed. So, but this one is there's a few, but yeah, I'll wait for you. You can wait to see that on Saturday.
I was gonna say with the bout situation, the way you were stripped last year, obviously none of it was ideal or convenient for you, but you come back now as the challenger. You said before that you feel like the champion. I want to know what mentality will kind of serve you better come Saturday. Are you kind of thinking like the challenger? Does it make you a bit hungrier? Or does it feel almost like a title defense?
No, for me, in my mind, I'm a world champion. Like I said, I haven't been beat in the ring. I got stripped. I got that confidence of being a world champion. When you become a world champion, it's like you level up. You got to keep stepping up because there's always someone who come behind you wanting to take your title. Yeah, I haven't got it, and I haven't got the title, although I got the real one sitting above my media wall, but I haven't actually got the title now as a world champion. But that confidence I've got from becoming a world champion and being around in the gym, the aura that is in the gym, yeah, it's going to be hard to compete with that, what I got. Although he's a world champion, he won a bigger title, so yeah, it's not the same.
And he beat somebody that is boxing on the undercards, Zalpha Barrett. If he's able to get past his opponent on Saturday night, and you are as well, then that will tee up a massive domestic clash for a world title. Have you paid much attention to that fight? Have you had to kind of answer too many questions about a potential fight with you and Zalpha down the line?
Down the line, yeah. That won't happen next, for sure. No taking away nothing from the kid he's fighting or Zalpha. But you can jump in straight into a title shot after fighting someone like that, especially when you've just lost one before. You'll have to wait a little bit longer. But I wanna unify. But that fight will definitely happen. But he has to, for me, he has to fight and get a recognisable win. So yeah, it is what it is. But that fight won't happen next.
You've been asked about a big name across the pond, Shakur Stevenson, who is billed as almost a phenom. You're our Welsh wizard, our Welsh phenom here, but to everyone in America, he is the next best thing. You've talked highly about that fight, and you said, you know, obviously you back yourself and you think you got what it takes, and you think that fight can be made. So is that what you want next if you're able to defeat Rakhimov on the weekend?
I'd love it, but I think his goals a little bit different to what mine are now. Same, but different weights. We were the same weight. He did call me out, and I accepted. He didn't make the weight. He moved up, and he still shouted that he would be happy to do a catch weight. But yeah, I think that it's just as time goes on, that fight's getting further and further away. So, yeah, listen. By the time if he did say he wanted a fight, I'd probably have to wait a little bit longer. When in the meantime, I could fight for a unification or something like that. Obviously, I got to do my job on Saturday and get my title back first and foremost. But yeah, I think that's, as time's going on, that fight's drifting away. So yeah, I'm happy for him. He's one of the best pound for pound fighters on the planet. And but yeah, if he did want the fights, I'd welcome it with both open arms.
And elsewhere in the world of boxing and in the news especially, obviously Conor Benn's been a rolling story. I'm sure you've had to do a lot of talking about it, being a campmate of his and one in the gym. What have you made of all the news? And have you been in touch with Conor since the news that you kind of suspended him?
To be honest, I don't really go to read all the stuff in the media and all that sort of stuff. So yeah, I just see him in the gym every day. He's training hard, he's grafting, and yeah. That's all I can say, really.
Does he push you on? What is your guys' kind of relationship like that? Outside of all the controversy, you know, how good of a teammate is he to you and you to him?
Oh yeah, everyone in our gym, it's good to be around. Yeah, we all got the same goals. We all work hard. We all push each other. We're all trying to compete into who's the better, not the better fighters, because we're all in different stages of our careers. But we're all trying to better each other in, I won this title, I won that title. Like me and Craig, Spider Richards, every time he's like, yeah, but I beat so many undefeated fighters. I said, I don't care, I won a world title in 15 fights. And I just point up at the board and my foot was there with the world title and all my other titles. And I said, how many titles you got? And we have a little banter back and forth, but everyone in that gym is good to be around.
And lastly, Joe, you were saying about unifications in your division. Obviously, we spoke about Shakur, but he's gone onto lightweight. Looking at your division, do you just want anyone who has a belt, or is there a name in particular for you?
Yeah, anyone who's got a belt, as soon as it can be made. But like I said, first and foremost, I got him to deal with Rakimov on Saturday, so that's the main thing for me.